What do you want? Where is your focus? Or do you feel that something else, some thoughts, some emotions, some triggers, bottle of alcohol, an alcohol commercial, pharma commercial, drug movie, is influencing your focus in such a way that it tells you what to want, or it is influencing what you want, such as, I can't get the thought of drinking out of my head, weed out of my head, heroin out of my head, cocaine out of my head, benzos out of my head. I'm trying to quit, but all I can think about is this drug or this drink. And that's where I'm stuck. How do I do it, Anthony? What do I do? What's the secret magic pill? Actually, the simple thing is to change your mind. Like, change your mind. Think about something else. Focus on something else. But what if I can't do that? Well, you can. What if I can't do that for long, you say, or, you know, consistently? What have you tried? Have you tried? Are you doing it in a way that is helping you win, or are you doing it in a way that is helping you lose? In other words, what focus are you employing and for what reason? Sorry, I'm getting a little bit psychological here as to motivations, but factually, when you're really in the present and you have to be there, your attention is all here. It is not on drinking or drugs. And if it is, it's very marginally so, and it is maximally on the situation at hand. That, by the way, is the major reason why drug addicts, alcoholics, pharma users induce anxiety attacks, get into crazy trouble, crash their life, tell lies, do crazy, stupid stuff, get themselves into major trouble, is to induce that sense of urgency that pulls all their attention to the present so they can not only act, but they can function. And I said function. I did not say function better. Many individuals are setting themselves up into these crazy situations or these catastrophic situations, so we believe, or these problematic situations that we see for one simple reason. They are trying to pull their attention. They're trying to create the conditions where their attention is so hyper-focused on the present that they can become active and competent or functional in those situations. It's actually a major reason for drug use, actually. One of my many, many callers and many, many clients, but many more callers and clients, has often said is that the main reason they do drugs, they drink, they're doing stuff that they're doing is because they're bored. Now, what happens when a person's bored? Well, what is boredom? It's wandering attention with an inability to fix it on any one particular thing for any length of time. So it's like, oh, you know, oh yeah, that shirt, that situation, that drink, that, oh, relationship, that conversation. And nothing really sticks. It's all just, whatever. That's boredom. And in order to function effectively, really one needs to fix their attention on some particular task or situation or object or person or even emotion for a length of time so they can actually do something effective about it and be present while they're doing it. It's very, very difficult to get dressed while you're actually in your mind thinking about all the various food you're going to eat or how you're going to cook next meal, unless you've got dressing down to the art of complete automaticity. But if you're also walking and moving and trying to dress while thinking about how are you going to prepare your food and what you're going to do and who needs to be present, most likely you're tripping around and falling occasionally because it's difficult to juggle those things. Although people who force themselves into these situations where all their attention's demanded and they have all their attention on the next thing that they need to accomplish, then magically they do each thing. So my point is, this demand for bringing all this attention has value, it has use, and it is also incredibly taxing, massively taxing. It actually takes years off your life and causes other problems that can be very severe. An inability to shut off that mechanism is an ability. Some people have a hard time going to sleep at night. By talking to you, perhaps. Why is that? Is it because you can't shut off all those functions and all those triggers and all those actions that you've set up in order to keep yourself focused and having attention on all those things you absolutely have to have attention on? And so demand or somewhat hold hostage yourself throughout the entire day, throughout the entire day to get stuck in that bad or that reeling situation of, you know, sort of perpetual fight or flight, and then wonder why you're having a hard time shutting it off. That's one of the major causes, but not the only cause. There are other factors of an inability to comfortably go to sleep at night. And there's a whole procedure that we can go on. Actually, I'm going to have fun with this one, but I do have a program called Conscious Sleeping, okay, or better, Conscious Preparation to Sleep. It's a better way of putting it. I thought it was kind of funny. Conscious sleeping. But anyway, these self-induced circumstances that we are creating throughout the day and having a difficult time shutting down maybe aren't a good thing in the first place. Perhaps that out-of-controlness of those circumstances that you're creating just so you can be present enough to take action, perhaps that is the wrong solution that you've been inducing that is causing your drive to drink, you believe, your drive to use drugs, your drive to smoke weed, your drive to do pharma, to shut off that action that you generated in the first place. I hope you've gotten a lot out of this video. I went deep on it in the, if you will, the philosophy and the, I'll just call it philosophy for now, and psychology of why we are in the situations and the circumstances we are, how we self-perpetuate these situations, and how by becoming conscious about them, we can radically and massively change our relationship with them, and so change our demands, change our needs, and also change our lifestyles in a way that best serves us. I'm Anthony Recovery Coach. You can find me at anthonyrecoverycoach.com. The topic today is focus, using your focus to determine your life and your life outcome.